Welcome to Statesmen, the podcast where we explore all 50 states with our five senses. If you've come here for history, we're giving you none. This is an ending episode, so all of this will be half-baked opinion that was never intended to harm or offend anyone. The end. Humanity has been contemplating the end for millennia. Will the world end in a Hollywood blockbuster the day after tomorrow? Or will it just keep on spinning? The nature of these questions is simply unknowable for what truly ends. If the quantum vacuum encodes the information of our bodies into the fabric of the universe like it does the sounds of birds and the color of their plumage, do we ever go away? Have we ever gone away already? Perhaps the end is but a brief flash that shines the way into a new beginning. The only thing that ends, according to science, is a tournament deathmatch, the only appropriate end for a cabal of some of the most vicious states found in the state realm. Who will meet their end, and who will see it through? Find out today in Mortal Statebat! I'm your elder statesman, Tim Ferrari, along with my junior statesman, Anthony Rossi.
Get over here!
And Stuart Hycar.
The president has just announced that we have caught and compromised to a permanent end the Statesmen Podcast.
Wow.
Wow.
You can't see him because it's an audio medium.
Yes, I am so sorry, everybody. A tear went down my face, quoting John Cena's announcement of the Bin Laden death. Of course, one of the best videos on the internet and one of the greatest pieces of our modern history. But Anthony, of course, I didn't want to skip over the fact that you pretended to be Scorpion.
Pretended? Listen, folks, we're going out with a bang, so there's going to be a big reveal every episode, the first of which, the first little present you get to unwrap, I am Scorpion.
Okay, cool, okay, man.
Yeah, the first big announcement on these, for listeners at home, you probably see this as part one. There will be a three-part trilogy of Mortal Statebat to say goodbye to the Statesmen Podcast, and each one will have a massive reveal on it. Anthony, of course, just getting right to it on this one, that he is, in fact, the skeleton from hell with a chain in his palm, Scorpion.
Mm-hmm, and you can catch me in the theaters shortly, hopefully, if you're vaccinated.
Oh, God, we hope so, man. How do you feel about that Sub-Zero?
Complicated relationship. We don't have time. Does anybody else have a reveal they want to drop on our listeners?
I don't know. Tim, do you have any, like, huge reveals or secrets that you feel like now's the time to get out?
I could probably tell you about my cat's shoulders, but I just think that might be too much information.
Yeah, damn. His shoulders. Shoulders?
Yeah, my cat's shoulders. They're, that's too much information. I can't divulge anything about his shoulders.
Two reveals about prominent blades.
Wow, this episode's starting with some heat, throwing fire, much like Scorpion's fireballs. And of course, as I said, this is the first of a trilogy of finale episodes for the Statesmen, where we will be finally crowning the one and true best state of all. And if this was another famous trilogy, you could consider this our Batman Begins. Isn't that correct, boys?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm so hesitant to say literally anything.
I feel like I've been sprayed with Scarecrow's magical mist because this is a nightmare so far.
Absolutely terrifying from front to back. Everything is turning into spooky stuff in the night. But I think it's also, we're going to see that this spooky stuff is actually very, very funny. Tim?
Yeah, well, you know what? Why don't we just get on with it? We'll introduce the premise of this show once we introduce our guest. He trusts us to shoot from the hip and from the heart. It's Mohawk Johnson.
Hi, everybody. Happy to be back.
Wow. Happy
Anthony,
to have you back.
You really got on here and said, I have secretly been an imaginary Japanese revenant the entire time.
Yeah. I mean, for all of those of you at home who, you know, this is probably coming to a surprise for those listeners who haven't seen pictures of Anthony.
Right.
But he does cover most of his face with a very cool sort of gunmetal gray mask at all times, because I assume there's a skull under there.
Yes, and perhaps you'll get a peek by the end of the episode. But Mohawk, thank you for joining us. This is a momentous occasion. Of course, we needed a momentous guest, and we thought of you right away. We knew that you're not going to be easy on any of these states and let any of these losers slip right through.
Oh, absolutely not. I'm Batman Begins.
Yes, that's right. And I do think we're going to come out with some solid stuff by the end of this episode. We're making hard decisions today, but you know, when you make a good omelet, you crack half a dozen eggs, and Anthony, you look like you're ready to crack some shell.
Absolutely. What the shell? Let's see what's inside.
What the Mohawk shredder did you just say? I'm sorry.
Mohawk, there's been a burning question on my mind, not burning because I'm Scorpion, of course, but burning because I'm just very, very curious. Since the last time you were on the show, how many times have you rewatched Sweet Home Alabama?
No, I've watched it no times.
Oh, damn. Okay, cool. So
my stepdad's from Alabama, and you know, thank God he got out.
An escapee. That's right. That movie felt like we were in prison while watching it. And Anthony, I had completely wiped it from my memory before you just said those words. So
yeah, me too.
All those memories rushing right back to me. But
I don't trust Reese Witherspoon anymore.
Did you beforehand? Did you have a pretty trustworthy relationship?
Yes, because of Legally Blonde.
Right. Yeah. She
I
does
loved
the right
her.
Thing. And now?
No. Her dad over here yelling, "The South shall rise again," because a fist fight happened. Just a strange.
God. She punched the mayor of New York. How right. I had forgotten. God, what a movie.
Is this something, guys, like Rhesus Witherspoon, but like Rhesus Monkey?
Hold on.
Okay, well, you know,
maybe like a Reese's Pieces.
No, 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 we can move on. No, 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 we can move on.
No, what? No. I want to unpack what just happened.
Look, we can unpack after this, but I think we need to at the very least explain the concept of this episode. And while some of you may understand immediately by the title, Mortal Statebat, Anthony, do you want to break down, I know, do you want to break down a little bit more what exactly we're going to be doing today?
Yeah, so you touched on it a lot earlier. We're going to get to the bottom of what is the best state. Now, what better way to do that than to gather together all of the states in a bracket? You know, we love brackets here on the Statesmen Podcast. Gather them all together in a bracket. Randomize the order. You can't do it alphabetically. Some states have to have bye weeks. You know, it's an imperfect bracket. You gotta jam some states straight through to the second round. So the only fair way to do it was by pure chance. So mm-hmm. Tim, our leader, the elder statesman himself, you know, jumbled these up and put them into the bracket for us. And we each are looking at this bracket. And throughout a series of rounds over the course of the next few episodes, we're going to slowly chip away at the loser states. And of mm-hmm. course, you know, we've uncovered through the course of this podcast, of course, pretty much every state has there's no good states, outright good states. Every state has horrible pieces to its history, horrible pieces of its current, you know, standing in the world. And we've also discussed how each state is not represented by its worst people or its worst, you know, impression on the world.
Sure.
But you have to take those into account. So we will each use our own set of criteria to arrive at the conclusion of which state should advance from here. And then ultimately, by the final episode of our show, we will get out the door with the crown on the head of the best state there is.
That's right. An unbelievable honor for whichever state that may be. Right now, it's up in the air. All 50 are in the competition. There are some people who argued that Puerto Rico and Washington, D.C. should have been included. You know, I'm so sorry for all of you out there. Unfortunately, the arrow of truth is long, but it does bend towards positivity, I think is a great quote. I really massacred that quote.
Beautiful.
What I'm trying to say is that at some point, hopefully those states will be brought into statehood, and then this bracket will be obsolete, null and void. But for now, this is the final statement on what the best state is.
Wow. And in this first round, we have 18 state matchups. That means we have 36 states head to head versus each other.
Wow. Okay, so before we really get into these matchups, I feel like maybe we should go around and explain what criteria we're going to be judging on, just so that people at home can kind of follow along. So Mohawk, I know, you know, you've had a long history of judging things, but how are you going to be deciding which state wins in these head to heads?
Randomly and ridiculously to maximize funny.
That is
okay.
That
the is R and R, the Twin Peaks Diner, ridiculous and random.
Okay, what about you, Stu? What's your voting criteria?
I'm all about the people. That's right, baby. I'm going to be looking at population sizes as well as some of the famous folks to come out of these states. I want to be deciding from the beating hearts that these states contain, and maybe the formerly beating hearts as well if there's some famous dead folks in the state. But Anthony, how about you?
I recognize, you know, I'm looking at these states through an imperfect lens, my personal experience and what they bring to mind for me. I'm going to be looking at them in terms of which state would I most want to live out my final days in and ultimately arrive at the paradise, which is a question we ask pretty much all of our guests.
Interesting. Where you will arrive to paradise from. Interesting. Tim, and how will you be grading these states?
Well, these states are in a heat of the, you know, they're in a blood match, and I have to rate it by combat. So I will be ranking them by the amount of combos that they perform, the finesse by which they perform those combos, and of course, their finishing move upon the opponent's state.
Wow. Okay. So you're going to be judging when the state clicks L and R at the same time with a full X meter. What happens?
That's right. And if they actually are able to pull it off, I mean, you know, some of these states might totally whiff their finishing move, and I'm going to count it against them.
Ouch. Wow. Ouch. Okay. Well, I mean, I'm feeling pretty much set up to get into this, but do we have any questions, concerns before we go in? And we want to maybe talk about Batman Begins a little bit more.
Yeah, I want to do both of that. All of the both. one, this is not a question or a concern, more of a comment. As a black guy, I don't like it here, so I ain't going to like none of these states.
Oh, yeah.
I think that's very fair. Yeah,
I don't like none of this shit.
I think a fair perspective to have.
Y'all not doing this right. Y'all not doing this shit right. This nation stuff, nah. And in regards to Batman Begins, I think I have some very harsh critiques of Batman Begins. And I know it was the first movie in a franchise. And, you know, Christopher Nolan was really like getting in there as to what he's capable of. But I do believe Ra's al Ghul's character was very wasted.
Yeah.
And I think it is very strange that they trained Bruce on how to fight, but did not train him on their philosophy about crime. That they just surprised him with the extremism. It's like, oh, whoops, we're terrorists, but we taught you kung fu. So it's like, yeah. Nah, bro.
It's kind of like if ISIS made Rambo and then told him they were ISIS at the end.
Yeah, like you know, that's not how you properly indoctrinate people.
You'd start with the beliefs, I would assume. Yeah, you don't want to make the guy dangerous.
Both simultaneously, and you find people who are desperate. And right. Then you train. It's just so strange. It's just.
And look, we don't even need to get into the fact that Ra's al Ghul, I mean, technically like a Tibetan character, I believe, played by the very Scottish Liam Neeson. But, you know, that's Hollywood, baby.
You know, that's its own weird combination because Ra's al Ghul was like from somewhere and then made it to Tibet and then found the Lazarus Pit, which is what gives him his like immortality, but also makes him crazy. And they didn't do nothing with the Lazarus Pit.
Not
you know what I'm
thing.
Saying? Like, why would you? That's like his whole deal. That's like Hulk with no super strength and not green. Like, why did you do this?
I mean, I would watch a movie of the Hulk just never green and not strong, but I believe that's the film The Kids Are All Right. Pretty good. Pretty good flick. That's right. Tim?
Is this something? Batman Begibbons, like the monkey Gibbons.
What is going on?
Anyway, well, you know, let's move on to round one of Mortal Statebat, where we start doing some of these states one-on-one in a bloody matchup of something. Mohawk has walked away from the...
Mohawk you walked away. Our guest.
Yeah, once I said the kids are all right, he left.
Okay. Oh, God. I'm sorry.
He's back.
I wasn't ready for that.
We got to get into round one because we have a lot of fights to talk about
still
today.
Still, I wasn't ready for that. I'm sorry.
Who's going head to head?
All right. In this first round, we have 18 matchups. And for the first bracket, we've got Virginia versus West Virginia. A sibling rivalry, this one.
Wow. Unbelievable. These are two states very close together, I assume. I'm not judging by geography, but I assume they're nearly kissing cousins. And now they're punching pappies.
Wow.
Anthony, how do you feel about this matchup?
You know, this is a tough matchup coming in. We, as a group, did not have a full successful West Virginia episode with a guest.
I mean,
it's a lost episode. It was a beautiful episode where we learned a lot about the heart of the state, and it is lost to the world. And then when we came back, we made it into fun little games. We know much more about Virginia, but I do think that there is, you know, kind of an understated heart to West Virginia. So I'm interested in this matchup right off the bat. It's a tough one to see right out of the gate. How do you feel?
I agree with what Anthony's saying. You know, we haven't seen what kind of combatant West Virginia is. We've seen the kind of blood that Virginia is able to pull from its roots. But West Virginia, we just don't know who this fighter is. So I just don't know who's going to win. Mohawk, what do you think about these two states going head to head?
Oh, West Virginia, period. I'm looking at Virginia and West Virginia, and Virginia has the size in this matchup, but like West Virginia has a West. Like, do you want Virginia or West Virginia? Do you want a cheeseburger or a bacon cheeseburger? You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's where I'm coming from. Like, West Virginia has, it's touching Ohio.
Yeah. It is slightly better because it has a direction associated.
It's got a direction.
Yeah, it's touching Ohio. Is regular Virginia touching Ohio? No. Fuck out of here.
No. And I mean, something that I think everyone should know, Virginia definitely has more in terms of population than West Virginia. West Virginia is sitting at about 1,792,000 people. However, Virginia is at 8,500,000 folks. So, I mean, definitely has a benefit there. But when we're talking about famous people, these are some shitty states, my friends. From Virginia, I mean, we're talking about pretty much every president from the first 10 presidents who were all just shitty, shitty.
All the slave owners.
Yeah, you know, you remember them from the walls of school.
My Negro senses are tingling.
Yeah, just hearing their birthplace mentioned. So pretty rude stuff there. But from West Virginia, there's a woman who's, she was the first real female superstar on television, known only as Dagmar.
That is
a D&D NPC. No, that is not a person. No, it's
that's
not.
Crazy.
That is an orc. That is a half orc, half tiefling.
An American actress, model, and television personality in the 1950s. She became one of the first major female stars of television, Dagmar.
You know, one thing that Virginia might have on West Virginia is the amount of horses that Virginia has. I think Virginia has more horses than West Virginia does.
But they probably also have more horse-related deaths.
Oh my God, so many.
You think about that, didn't you?
As a man myself who is very afraid of horses, I would stay away from the state that has more of them. But I guess, you know, if we're talking horse-related deaths, Anthony, which of these two, sorry, Scorpion, between these two states, which of these sounds like a better place to end your life?
Oh, man, it's tough. I was looking back at my notes for my presentations on these states, and there are some really beautiful state parks in each of these states. I'm not thrilled about the Pentagon being in Virginia. Dolly Sod's Wilderness is just a fun name that we, you know, lost on our lost episode for West Virginia. Didn't get to explore Dolly Sod's. I don't know. These are both states that have kind of like an underrated beauty to them. But I ultimately, am I passing my vote now?
I think maybe it's time for us to announce our votes. I think it's only right.
I gotta go Virginia, no West. I think the West does add a little bit of flair, but I think the size and the scope of Virginia feels a little more homey to me.
Wow. Interesting. A little more homey. Well, I mean, I'm going to even things up for us. I got to pick West Virginia, if only because it produced the incredible talent of Dagmar. I don't know what she did. I don't know what her story is. I just think it's crazy to have a mononym in the 50s and have it be Dagmar. So Dagmar. My vote, West Virginia.
Wow, Mohawk, what's your vote here?
Dagmar sounds like a Zack Snyder superhero origin movie. Like, that's
sounds sick.
That's a villain that Etrigan fights, if y'all know. Wow. Who Etrigan is.
Okay,
from DC.
Deep pool. And Zack's still at DC.
Yeah, no, comics, that I'm the dude for that. But yeah, no, West Virginia. It's West. Burger or cheeseburger? Cheeseburger or bacon cheeseburger? Right.
Wow, I think that's fair. So right now it's 2-1. Tim, you could either tie things up and send it to Camden for a final elimination choice, or you could decide this right now. How do you feel?
You know, I think it's simple. I'm rolling with Dagmar.
Wow! Fuck yeah. West Virginia heads to the second round, where it will be facing, if I'm not mistaken, Arkansas, who got a bye in the first round. Pretty exciting stuff there.
Yes, and just listeners, keep in mind, that was purely random. Arkansas is in a very fucking awful public light right now. Fuck Arkansas's public action right now and the laws they're trying to fucking get through. Fuck that, absolutely. But purely random. We'll address that when we have to.
We'll get
But for
there.
Now, West Virginia, moving on.
Wow, exciting.
Dagmar.
In the first round, the second seed, that's what it's called, right? A seed?
That's right.
Seeds. All right. First round, second seed, we've got Kansas versus Iowa.
Whoa.
Wow.
Wow. Okay. Now this is a matchup. Right off the bat, Tim, I want to know what you're thinking.
Two capitals of the world. We've got the potato capital of the world. We've got the wheat/bread capital of the world, and maybe even the corn capital of the world. These are two powerhouse hitters, slow heavies. You know, this is like Bowser versus Ganondorf.
Okay, which one is Ganondorf and which one is Bowser?
Great question. That's I gotta say, I think personally, Kansas is Bowser, because I think it's a little bit more like basic, and everybody knows Bowser, everybody knows Kansas. Iowa, I think, holds some secrets, and it's come in many forms, much like the evil of Ganondorf.
Mm.
Am I right about this?
I'd say so. I think that's a fair assessment.
Well, thank God, because looking at the populations, I mean, I'm having trouble even finding. Oh, no, they're actually very similar. Iowa has 3.1 million people and Kansas 2.9. So Kansas, a little bit less, but I'll have to take a look at celebrities to see if that changes anything. And oh my goodness gracious. I thought this was a joke or a prank at first, but it's not. It's true. From Iowa, the man himself, the Kutch dog, Ashton Kutcher.
Wait. That's got to be, you're punking us right now. I'm
no,
looking for a camera.
That makes perfect sense. Ashton Kutcher? That's an Iowa name.
That's Iowa as hell. And here's a name that's even more Kansas related. Harrison Ford. That's as American as it fucking gets. Harrison. Wow. I mean, two superstar guys who have probably had earrings at the wrong times in their lives. I'm having a lot of trouble with this one. Anthony, how do you feel about this?
another tough matchup right out of the gate, but for a different reason. These are both Midwest staples. And it's tough to see one of these go right away. In my opinion, they're a worthy matchup. I agree. This is like a tough head to head. Both are coming to fight hard. But I do think I have a winner in mind.
Wow. Okay. Well, I feel like we should ask, Tim, you know, in terms of combos, what are you thinking?
I mean, in terms of combos, I think Iowa is clearly pulling ahead in this one. Kansas can only throw so much bread at Iowa's way while Iowa has a potato gun. I mean, there's just no comparison in between the two to me. While they're both kind of flat and fieldy, Iowa has some green to it. It's got some money. Kansas, yellow.
Ouch. Ouch. Yellow. The worst of colors.
The Coldplay color.
Oh,
what does that mean?
We cannot keep talking about this song on every episode. Mohawk, listen to Coldplay's Yellow if you really want to learn how to feel.
No.
Between Kansas and Iowa, which state right off the bat is interesting you more? Who do you think is going
to
win?
I don't know. It really comes down to who would win in a fight between Han Solo and Kelso.
Wow. A head-to-head we've been waiting for.
I think Han Solo's got it. I think Han Solo could beat up that teenage boy. or Indiana Jones versus a white guy from a rom-com.
I was going to say, name one other white guy character from Ashton Kutcher's ever played.
Right, can Indiana Jones beat up a white guy in a rom-com? Or would Indiana Jones just be another white guy in the same rom-com?
Good questions all. But
Han Solo can beat Kelso.
I think that's probably true. I think it's a close fight, but I do think Kelso will die. And so,
where is that close?
Where is it close? I think Harrison Ford has really bad heart problems. I think there's a chance that the young age of Ashton.
I mean, I'm talking like them in their prime. I'm talking their characters as we remember them, not their characters as we see them. Like young Han Solo, I shot first is gonna murk. I'm not old enough to drive yet, Kelso.
Like that's an interesting question. Because do we include their most iconic weapons, Han Solo's blaster and Ashton Kutcher's missing car?
Look, we need to fucking. Who's gonna win this match?
Who I'm winning my race vote between the Millennium Falcon and a car and so a fast, missing can't car. Find it.
All right, I'm putting my vote in, guys. I'm doing it, and really, something helped me decide this. You know, it wasn't the two celebrities who I already named. It was a different celebrity from the great state of Kansas, and that is the host of Survivor, Jeff Probst. I believe that any state that created the Probst is a Probst to move on to the next round. So my vote is for Kansas.
Wow. Anthony?
I hate to say it. I'm going Kansas as well. Iowa really won a spot in my heart throughout the course of the show. It was a state I came in with no feelings about whatsoever. And our two guests really brought the light of that state to me. But Kansas, I mean, it's undeniable. I want that barbecue. I'm choosing with my tongue here. And that's Kansas.
Wow.
Oh, okay.
Mohawk, what Kansas. Do you think?
Kansas.
I cannot believe this.
I'm choosing Kansas.
That's a sweep for Kansas. But Tim, just out of interest, who would you have picked?
I mean, I was picking Iowa, you know, from the get-go. I was seeing Iowa's finishing move in my head, stuffing a potato down Kansas's throat or some shit like that. But I didn't even get to see that. I got I got wheat. Kansas stuffed the stomach of Iowa with a bale of hay. Cool.
Okay, now Tim, I raise you this. That is a good finishing move, but it is a grapple, and Kansas is a range fighter. How would they hit?
Whoa.
So it's not it's unblockable, but it needs to make contact, and Kansas is a mid to long range fighter.
Wow.
I didn't even see this coming. So I thought, in my mind, Iowa was the ranged fighter with the potato gun. Shooting a potato into the throat, maybe even through the back of the head of Kansas.
I think it has ranged weapons the way like most Mortal Kombat characters do. But mm-hmm. I think it's close-up action because you got to load that potato gun. Like, you got to get that thing ready. You know what I'm saying? Mm. And then the recoil, the accuracy, the only being able to shoot one round at a time. You know what I'm saying?
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. You could probably do a fire from the hip burst shot if you hit back square. But
I thought it was back forward square.
Hmm. Whatever it may be, Kansas won the fucking round, guys. So we should let it go on. I don't think, look, it's already in round two and we have to decide who it's going to fight in round two. So Tim, with the third seed in the first round, who is fighting?
Wow. Well, we've got a snowy beast in Vermont going up against the Tornado Alley capital of the world, Oklahoma.
Whoa, Oklahoma. Okay, but I mean, Vermont, these are really interesting states. Very, very different in their populations, very different mm-hmm. in their cultures, geographically very different. Anthony, right off the bat, what are you seeing as the major pros and cons of each state?
Well, Vermont, Ben and Jerry and Jen and Barry, the best ice cream in the world. You got quality maple syrup. You got the gorgeous foliage. Oklahoma, you had the wide open plains, you have interesting weather, you have a fucking musical named after the state, ooh. And you have the memories that we made on those episodes doing our famous Homer Simpson impressions.
Okay.
Guys, this episode's all about yellow. My wardrobe is Scorpion, Coldplay, Homer Simpson.
Wow.
I will say, though, this particular matchup is the easiest one we've had so far in my book. This one is a walk for me. Stu, how are you feeling?
Wow, okay. So I'm honestly a little bit surprised to hear that from you, but you are using different criteria than me, you know? You're definitely looking at things or places that you'd like to die, and I'm looking at the people from these states. And, I mean, just to get started, Vermont has a very, very small population. Let me pull it up here. It is the 50th. Oh man, almost at the bottom other than Wyoming. 623,000 people live in Vermont. Just obviously not a lot, but it is a tiny little state, close-knit community. However, Oklahoma, 3.9 million. Big boy. And for me, size often takes it in these rounds. But Vermont is smaller, but does it know how to use it? That's the question. Mohawk, how are you feeling about Oklahoma versus Vermont?
I mean, Vermont, I have a friend named Dana from Vermont who I met when I first started working at Second City. And the reason I remember her so vividly and Vermont so vividly is because she would talk to me and she would go, yo, because I'm from Vermont. And then she would finish the sentence. And
what?
She just talked about Vermont a lot. And that made me like her and Vermont. She's a very lovely person. I hope she's doing well. And
interesting.
And you know, but Oklahoma has tornadoes. So my thing is can Oklahoma control the tornadoes like an airbender in this fight? Or is Oklahoma constantly losing fights to its own wind?
Wow, yeah, being destroyed, hoisted by their own petard. An interesting point. Does Oklahoma control the tornadoes or are they something that's been beset upon them? And does Vermont have any natural disasters that we know of? I mean, like avalanches? Do avalanches count?
Do avalanches happen in Vermont? I feel like there's I never hear about mountains. Avalanche natural disasters. I feel like that doesn't happen.
Okay, well, the Avalanche got scored on 3-0 playing the Oilers last night. That's a bit of a natural disaster, you know what I mean?
What is that?
Anywho, oh my God. It's hockey. It's a sport no one cares about. I think, let me do a little breakdown here of some famous people from each state. This does help me decide a little bit. Oklahoma, Dr. Phil.
Wow.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, it's right.
The kids love it. A real doctor giving real advice. And then from Vermont, I mean, the stars are not great. I mean, the Sam Lloyd, he was, I believe, a therapist in Scrubs.
Cool.
Okay, yeah, well, hold on. JoJo.
Okay, hell yeah.
Wait, Brigham the singer JoJo, Young, not JoJo Siwa.
Not JoJo Siwa. Let me clarify. JoJo Siwa was not born on any state. She was born in the stars, and that's where she will return when her channel is finally fucking deleted from YouTube, if they ever read my emails. Who else we got here? John Deere and Aaron Lewis. Who's Aaron Lewis, you may ask?
Who?
Who he is the lead singer of Stained?
Oh,
oh, sure. I saw Stained in concert. They headlined for Three Doors Down. Or no, not headlined. They
opened.
Opened for.
Wow, what a concert!
Just as we promised, listeners. Tim did drop another sizzling reveal for the audience members at home. He saw Stained in concert.
Wow. Unbelievable. Not just Stain, but also Three Doors Down. If I go crazy, will you still call me Stuart? Well, let's go ahead and decide who won this round. I mean, these are two states that I think you can go either way. It's just your own personal preference. Me, I think I got to put the vote in for Vermont. I see it as a very progressive place. The people who come from there are very progressive. Bernie alone, king, we make him our king. We make him our ruler. He should rule over all of us. So my vote's going to Vermont. But honestly, I'm curious to see what everyone else is voting for. Tim?
Well, for me, of course, this matchup is going to come down to how these two states are going to fight up against each other. We know that Vermont is one of the smallest states in this competition, but it's going to use its size, I think, as a defensive strategy. This is going to be a sort of turtley state with a spiky outside in its mountains.
Turtley.
And it's got sort of a Johnny Cage kind of feel, you know, in terms of personality, you know, small guy, big personality, and they ski, you know, so Oklahoma doesn't really have all that much to it. So I've got to say, simply for finesse, Vermont's taking it home for me.
Wow. Okay, so Vermont with two votes. I think I want to come to Mohawk here. Mohawk, between Oklahoma and Vermont, which of these two states is standing out to you as more interesting? Who's going
to
win?
You inspired me to look up more celebrities from Vermont, and this is actually skewing my answer a little bit. Hmm. Philip Maxwell is from Vermont, who Maxwell Street in Chicago was named for, ergo Maxwell Street Polish.
Oh, hold on a minute.
Which means we would not have the Polishes without Vermont.
Hold on. There's no way that's how this relates. Is that, did he bring the Polish identity to Chicago?
No, he just brought the street was named after him. Chicago has a lot of streets named after like famous Polish people. Like I think Pulaski.
Oh, for sure.
So, you know, like, Vermont is a part of Chicago history and a part of my tum-tum. And for that, I will pick Vermont.
Wow.
Wow. Okay. Wow. I mean, I think that's pretty much going to be a clean sweep, unless, Anthony, who were you thinking?
You know, I said that it was an easy one for me. Of course, I was going to vote from Vermont, my neighbor in the Northeast, very close to my heart, and one of the most beautiful states we've seen.
Absolutely. And a good choice. A proper sweep for Vermont. The floor is clean. Let's move on to our next round, Tim.
Yeah, so this fourth seed, I mean, we haven't seen a champion enter the arena quite yet, but in this round we are seeing two champions head to head. We've got California versus Massachusetts.
Wow.
Two powerhouse states.
Wow.
I mean,
very competitive states, one from the East Coast, one from the West Coast.
It's Lakers Celtics, baby.
Ooh. Yeah. Wow. Which state has more magic and which state has more birds? Caw-caw!
Great question, Anthony. Which state does have more birds? We'll get down to it in our conversation. But Mohawk, off the top of your head, you hear Massachusetts, you hear California. I know what I think of, but which of these are you feeling more interested in?
I'm from New York, so I have a relationship with Boston.
And is that a positive relationship?
It is one. It just is. Because, like, Revolutionary War, you know, that was our homie, you know what I'm saying? But also, sure. I was black, so none of that was about me. Except for, like, the British offering us freedom, which was very weird, because if we was British colonies, they should have just made them let us go.
from jump
earlier.
Sure. If that's how they felt.
Important to remember that only the shittiest people came over to start America in the beginning. It was just like these Protestant buckle wearing assholes. So, I mean, if just like one nicer person had come over, things could have been different.
Also, isn't Salem in Massachusetts?
It is. That's right.
Yeah, witches. Burning women for literacy? No. but California keeps electing famous Republicans because they're famous.
True. Very true.
And that that's dangerous. Like, I don't know much about like Arnold Schwarzenegger's foreign or domestic policy as a governor because I don't know what governors do. But I do know that people in prison have to fight fires for almost no money.
Sure.
And then when they get released from prison, they can't even become firefighters because that's a government job and you have a felony on your record, which is dangerous and oppressive.
I feel like both of these states are sort of juggling their own weird liberal racism shit, where like Boston is like thought of as like a blue state, but like everyone in Boston is just the shittiest fucking open racist person in the world. I mean, not everyone. Shout out Willie. I'm so sorry. But I do think there is like a lot of open racism there. And California is the other side of that liberal coin where it's like, we want you to tell us we're not racist, even though we actively vote for tons of policies that like fuck over anyone who isn't a rich white Silicon Valley guy.
I don't think I have an answer because I don't know what sort of white, I don't know what type of white supremacy I'm willing to abide today.
You're willing to vote for
that every election season, I'm just like, all right, which one of y'all, how do I want to be hated?
For sure.
For the next 4 years.
This whole bracket seems to be, you know, just that.
Right.
Kind of is, yeah. So I guess we kind of, between Massachusetts and California, have to look at some pros. In my head, I mean, obviously, you know, who's some famous people from California? I mean, our cop vice president, Kamala Harris, she's a pig. You know, Tom Brady, shout out to apparently the GOAT. I'm making a full that's right, Anthony, I said it, the GOAT. I'm making a full barnyard of people. And Elizabeth Olsen, the Scarlet Witch, who's taking care of the barnyard.
this is the most motley crew.
It's a crazy crew of people. But Massachusetts is just like Edgar Allan Poe and Mark Wahlberg. So, you know, like, I don't know. This is a tough one. Anthony, between these two states, is there one that you'd more prefer to die in? And remember that John Krasinski is from Massachusetts.
Wow. Well, I thought I had it figured out, but now I'm reeling thinking about all the times he looked into the camera on The Office and in Jack Ryan. I don't know. This is a very close battle to my heart. It's some of the best beaches in the East versus some of the best beaches in the West. It's dreams versus hard-nosed family. I think that this is a tough one. You know, I definitely have spent a lot of time in each state, largely because I've been visiting family. Or on vacation. Like there are spots that work in either application. And I think that everybody does kind of have this perception from the outside that Massachusetts is only racist and California is a liberal safe haven. And that's not necessarily true on either count. But with all said and done, like head to head like this in this matchup, I do have to vote for California.
Oh, okay. Wow. Interesting. Tim, I mean, I haven't heard your combos. What are some final moves? What are you thinking?
I mean, you know, of course, Massachusetts is going to be bringing its big, burly sort of build, haymaker style over the shoulder. We're talking shirtless and hairy. While California is kind of coming with a samurai sword of sorts, you know, we're whipping out the katana, dual wielding on a surfboard. And they're wearing shorts. So much cooler outfit, much cooler finesse. Combos are, you know, they're pulling both combos and shittiness. And the finishing moves, I don't know. What does Massachusetts do? Shove a Boston cream pie into the stomach of California?
Why is it always them like shoving an object into the body of the other state? I want to mention specifically between these two states. I mean, one of them has swimmable beaches and the other one doesn't, and I think that's like a huge benefit, but. I know you don't. I don't think Massachusetts beaches are swimmable. I'll say
I've been in that water. I'm
no,
fine.
You haven't. What are you talking you about? Have no, not done not. That. You're a liar. Fine. You're bad. You're wrong now. You're scorpion.
Scorpion.
Have you forgotten
scorpion? Oh yeah, I bet you went in the water and extinguished your eternal skull flame. Yeah, right. Come on, you can't swim
Nothing
in Massachusetts.
About you is okay. How dare you?
I mean, I think just out of like a love for maybe the beachy sort of West Coast vibe, I'm gonna go with California. But this is really like a big head to head. This is a classic like Massachusetts versus California, a tale as old as time. Mohawk, between these two, who are you feeling?
I think I'm leaning towards Massachusetts because Bill Burr is from Boston, and Bill Burr was in The Mandalorian. Which means there's a Boston in space in the future.
That's true.
Which means in our canon, because I live in Star Wars canon. That's our world. We're not there yet.
That's true. Actually, am I wrong in saying that it already happened a long, long time ago?
I think what George Lucas was doing was, and it's hard to understand what George Lucas is doing because oftentimes he doesn't know. I think what George Lucas was doing, because, you know, space and time are relative.
Right.
So, like, I think when you travel out there, or by the time those stories reached us, they already happened a long, long, long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. If we want to bring, like, theoretical physics into this.
Einstein.
And, like, astrophysics into that. You know, if you want to do string theory and stuff like that. And like, time and distortion and all the other things. Or... Mm-hmm. Or maybe he just didn't know how to write an opening line, and that was a terrible idea.
Okay.
Which is also true. Or maybe he was so far in the future that we're very far in the past. Like, we're the prequels to the prequels, and all the other stories also happened in his past because George Lucas lives in the year 4870.
4870, wow. Also, George Lucas's neck measurements. I think my man's got a big neck.
he looks like a frog in mid-crow.
He does. He looks like a frog, and it's crazy. It's like a... Yeah. I mean, like, so... Space, Mohawk going for Massachusetts. Tim, it comes down to you, I believe. We have two votes for California, one for Massachusetts. What are you thinking?
I mean, I gotta do it. I gotta go with what's warmer, what's hotter. You know, the finesse is there. It's California.
Ooh. Wow. Clam chowder.
I would like to contest the clam chowder is warmer than California because of the boiling point of
hotter
water.
Than any beach. That's a fact.
You know, how hot you got to get soup to cook?
I mean, pretty hot, I assume.
I'm sorry. California just summoned a tsunami tidal wave over Massachusetts in its finishing move. They were able to pull the hardest one off.
And that means that California is going on to round two, where it will be fighting another
state.
You can't
kill clams with a tsunami? They're clams.
In round two, California will be facing Mississippi, which got a bye to the second round, which another one that is just shocking to see. But that is the nature of the random coin flip, my friends. So let's move on to that that next one. Tim, who's going up head-to-head next?
In the fifth seed, oh my God, two more absolute giants. Yeah. We're looking at Texas and Colorado.
Oh, wow. This one hurts. This one hurts because, obviously, as the listeners know, I'm a Colorado native. I was raised at a high altitude, so my lungs are, God, they're so strong. And that's what lets me let out so much hot air on this podcast. But Texas, a pretty good state, a pretty big state. Some shitty stuff happening there. But the state overall is an interesting, you know, our cowboy state. Anthony, how do you feel about these two Goliaths going at each other?
I want to pay Texas the respect that it genuinely deserves. And I want the listener to interpret that as they will. I feel Texas deserves a certain amount of respect, and that is an indeterminate amount. I think that Colorado is a gorgeous natural state. I think Texas is very big. I think a lot of people live there. And I think that, you know, as we've discussed on our previous episodes, much like California, but kind of the opposite way, it's interpreted as this like monolith of Republicans with shitty opinions and shitty takes. But there is like a young, weird art community that dwells within it who wants to do better. That being said, it is extremely, you know, it's like three times over stolen land. So yeah, it's you know, that's baked into its history. It's certainly a state that takes itself very seriously and would be a tough contender in a physical fight. But Colorado, I don't know. I have a lot of attachment to Colorado as well. I'm interested to see how this shakes out.
Yeah, well, I mean, speaking of a physical fight, Tim, that's kind of your criteria. How are you feeling these two are coming up against each other?
Well, you know, Texas has the classic strength and the macho charisma of a cowboy. But one thing that Colorado has on Texas is its first move. Colorado wields a glass bong in its main hand. And when striking the first move, it's always a critical hit. Now, if Texas is able to block this critical hit, it might be over for Colorado.
Whoa.
What?
Holy shit.
So Colorado's putting everything they have into this first bong swing, a la Pineapple Express.
That's right, because then it's just able to steamroll the competition after that.
Okay. It's pretty good.
Absolutely smoked.
Yeah, but Mohawk, between these two options, I mean, Texas and Colorado, is there one that immediately is standing out to you as better?
No. Because Texas was the last state to let black people go.
That's true. Mm. Yes. That was the last place that the word of secession or the Emancipation Proclamation reached, like 2 years later, too.
Yeah. But Colorado looks like a state made of dandruff.
Now, is this because of the people who live there's whiteness or about the climate?
Yes.
Gotcha.
They inform each other.
I mean, you're not wrong. Colorado is, speaking from experience, insanely white, just horribly white. We have an interesting Latino population, but even that, I mean, like the amount of like people who I would describe as Latinx in my hometown who are super Trumpy is pretty surprising. It's an interesting energy in Colorado. But I mean, like, have you ever been to either of these states, Mohawk?
I've been to Texas.
Ah, okay. Anywhere in particular in there?
I've been to Dallas.
Was it worth it?
I was 12.
Okay, so good. So was it good?
It happened. You know, I was there for Thanksgiving. I met some family. I played Dragon Ball Z Budokai 1 on my GameCube a lot with my cousin. And we watched... That is the first time I saw the Lizzie McGuire movie.
Okay.
The first time I saw the Lizzie McGuire movie was there.
Indelible memories.
I also found out that one of my uncles was very homophobic.
It's Thanksgiving, yeah.
And Colorado looks like it's made of dandruff.
Man.
But I have dandruff sometimes because my scalp gets very dry, which is why I wear the bonnets that I normally wear in my TikToks. And I feel like I could fit right in if I just walk in and go, hey, everybody, and then I just scratch my head profusely. Wow. So whatever preconceived notions they have about me and my skin color will just go away because they'll go, oh, he's itchy too. He is our friend. And that's what I'm looking for.
And Mohawk, this may change your opinion, but another star of The Mandalorian from Texas, Gina Carano.
Oh, but we hate her.
Yeah, pretty hard.
Because transphobia. We don't...
Yeah, she kind of just sucks all around, but like, she is strong.
She's strong, and I loved her very deeply from the first time I saw her in the first Deadpool movie. I'm like, yes, yes, absolutely yes. Strong, funny, and then politics happen, and I'm like, oh, you would vote against my very existence.
Yeah.
You would literally vote in ways that could tangibly get me murdered. No. So that pushes me towards the no for Texas.
Okay, yeah, definitely understand why. And of course, I think it's important to note that Anna Sophia Robb of Because of Winn-Dixie fame was from Colorado. So say of that what you will. My vote, I mean, it's no surprise. I don't even have to say it. It's Colorado. I mean, I have to vote for my home state. Maybe that'll change in later rounds, but for now, gotta go Colorado.
Yeah, I agree. Colorado was able to overhand smash the bong onto the top of Texas's 10-gallon hat and ended up smoking the guy like a bong. So it's Colorado for me.
Anthony?
I'm not going to create any drama here with my pick. Colorado for me as well. I loved visiting it. I want to go back desperately. It's a place I'd definitely consider dying one day.
Wow.
Wow.
I mean, congrats, Colorado. Seems like an easy sweep, and you're heading into the next round where you'll face Maryland, who got a bye into the second round. Maryland, the place of crabs and logic. We love it on this pod. wow. Want to move on to the next place.
All right, for the sixth seed, we have Oregon and Delaware. A modest round. One of our first, I feel like.
I would agree. Yeah, neither of these is jumping out at me immediately as like the obvious winner. I don't know. Anthony, anything you see here?
Well, I definitely have an upper hand choice in this one. There's one that I think is just higher above and top of mind. I'm putting it out there. I'm going to go Oregon for this one.
Wow.
I think that Delaware is an interesting state. Another one I gained a lot of respect for in terms of this podcast. Had a lot of fun recording about Delaware with the Rune Dog. But I'm going to say Oregon, you know, there's more freedoms, not just with drugs, but I just think that it's a more interesting and beautiful state. I would much rather die there.
Wow.
Wow, that's fair. Okay, Mohawk, do you want to give us your thoughts and tell us your vote?
Yeah, well, Oregon has a trail.
That is true.
And Delaware, more like Delahoo.
Damn.
Whoa, what, when, where, why?
Exactly. Like, Oregon has a trail. Do you have a trail, Camden? Right.
No, Camden shaves. Tim, do you want to go ahead and tell us?
I took it there because I didn't want to.
Tim, do you want to tell us your thoughts and give us your vote?
Well, you know, just these fighters, they might as well not even be fighters. You know, they're monks stepping into the wrong sort of territory. But Delaware is sort of attacking me personally with sort of a psionic memory, as I had some previous past memories in Delaware where, you know, my 14, 15-year-old online girlfriend when I was 14, 15 years old when we met, you know, that she was from Delaware. So I'm having some psionic warfare going on in mine. And I have to, just by the psychic nature of the caster, Delaware.
Wow.
And you know what? I hate to be this person, but there are, you know, an interesting cast of celebrities from both places. I mean, let's just say the name. Beverly Cleary is from Oregon.
Who is that?
Wow.
I believe she wrote Ramona and Beezus.
What is that?
Am I right about this?
I don't know what Ramona and Beezus is.
Henry Huggins.
Beezus died for your sins.
Okay. Well,
Jesus of Beezus.
Well, I mean, like, this actually, that describes why I'm actually choosing who I'm choosing. The other state, Delaware, of course, has our main man from it, the guy who we all want to be, smoking a little rock, having sex on camera, Hunter Biden, the king, the crown prince of America. So I'm going to be choosing Delaware, which means we're all tied up, 2-2. Camden, finally a tiebreaker.
Gee, thanks, guys. It's producer Cam Stacey. Wow. Jeez. There's a lot to be said about Oregon. Oregon's a super mixed bag. Yes, they're way ahead of the game as far as legislature around substance use. And Portland has a special place in my heart, always will. And I really want to see the fabled Oregon coast before I die. I would definitely echo Anthony, and that's of the two, that's definitely where I'd rather die. Delaware, there's just not a lot to be said about Delaware. There's so much to be said about Oregon on both sides. A lot of good and a lot of bad. The Klan and a lot of white nationalism is alive and well in rural Oregon, but Delaware's got Joe Biden. So for sheer volume and portfolio, I think I'm gonna sway this Oregon's way.
Wow. Okay.
Thank you, Cam.
Right.
You made the right choice.
I appreciate the thumbs up.
Damn, Camden broke the tie, went with Oregon. I think it's a smart choice, but Tim, who's next?
Well, in the seventh seed, again, one more time, we have two very middling opponents, in my opinion. Maybe one's going to come on top. Indiana versus Arizona.
Oh, that's easy for me.
Let us hear it.
Arizona has a brand of iced tea. Indiana has corn and racist.
Mm. You're not wrong. Yeah,
Arizona also wrong. Probably has racist, but they're too spread out to hurt me.
Too old.
Right. So Arizona.
Yeah, I mean, Arizona. That's a solid pick. I'm going to jump in with mine here. And it has entirely to do with the celebrities from each state. Indiana, Mike Pence.
Yuck.
Arizona, David Spade. Arizona gets my vote. Yeah.
Arizona.
What do you think?
I mean, it's Arizona for me. I've spent more time there overall, visiting my grandma. It was fresh on my mind from our State at Home Round 2 special where I crushed my representation of Arizona. Do I have to go get the PS3 Madden cover or draw a line on a piece of paper?
Ugh.
Don't make me even do it right now.
Stop.
Arizona all the way. I'd rather die there in the hot, hot sun.
And just to round it out, I mean, just to make it a sweep, it's Arizona for me too. I mean, Indiana's coming at Arizona with absolutely nothing. And Arizona as a state reminds me of my favorite Pokemon, Sandshrew. So it's sand attacks all the way.
Hashtag
again.
Important.
Yeah, very important.
Hashtag important.
Do not forget Sandshrew.
Hashtag yellow again.
Arizona, use sand attack against Indiana and move
you
on to the next round.
Fuck out of Indiana's accuracy.
Wow, congratulations. So they'll move on, I believe. Wow, that's going to be a crazy second round going up against Nevada, who got the bye. Nevada v. Arizona, the desert round.
Wow.
Wow.
Some people talk about the dessert round after dinner. Take away an S.
Every round in this episode is a dessert round. They're all so sweet. In this eighth seed, we've got Michigan versus Idaho.
Wow. Interesting. And I think this one is pretty easy for me. It really has to do with celebrities. Okay. And when we're talking about Idaho, we're talking about one guy, Aaron Paul. Wow. Jesse from Breaking Bad and the lead character from the Need for Speed, the movie. So, I mean, this guy is all wins. But I mean, let's take a look at who's from Michigan. Uh-oh, it's Steven Seagal.
Ew.
That's right. A man who believes to be the
police.
He is a police officer. I believe he does have a badge, and he also believes himself to be the true reincarnation of the Dalai Lama. Steven Seagal, a twisted mind, and that is why I have to give this to Idaho, even though I don't give a shit about Idaho.
Have y'all seen Steven Seagal run?
Yeah, I have. It's not running. It's not running, man. It's his jacket's moving. He's not running.
He looks like a toy being dropped down the stairs.
Wow. I can honestly say in the few Steven Seagal movies I've seen, I've literally never seen the man run in my life. Oh,
God. Look at Under Siege 2.
Oh, a classic. There's this clip that was a very, very big just like a couple of days ago from a Steven Seagal movie where he's in China and there's these two characters who are speaking in Mandarin and they say their first two lines in Mandarin. And then Steven Seagal goes, "Hey, man, come on. Why don't we all just speak English?" And the other characters are like, okay. And they start. It's very interesting stuff. Anyway, Steven Seagal, you lost the round for Michigan. Idaho gets my vote. Anthony, who are you taking?
I'm taking Michigan here. Idaho, I don't really have a big opinion of. I did learn so much about it when we had the Nadal sisters on. Very, very interesting, more than just potatoes. Certainly potato full. A state I'd visit, not a state I'd want to die in. Michigan is my pick. I'd be dying in the Upper Peninsula.
Wow.
Tim.
Well, Idaho, I just, you know, I really don't imagine the fighter in Idaho, but for Michigan, I'm imagining sort of a master hand, sort of slapping the shit out of their opponents in a big hand format. So I think it slaps all around for Michigan for me. That one is my pick.
Wow. Okay. So I think this is coming down to Mohawk. There's a vote for Idaho. There's two for Michigan. What are you thinking?
Michigan. I didn't miss the first time. but
oh my God.
But Idaho, you know, check my Tinder. Don't
check my Tinder. Okay.
I don't have a Tinder. I'm not good at internet dating. So for me, it's going to be Idaho.
Wow.
Because yes, I am.
Okay.
Because yes, I'm is.
A couple of hoes, Mohawk and I, and that means Camden, you have to break another tie, my friend. Idaho and Michigan, who's going to take this round?
Between the only time in probably the past decade that Idaho has been in national news was for their mask burning party where people gathered around a 55-gallon drum that was on fire and tossed their face masks in there. And also considering most of my family is from Michigan and considering all that Detroit has done for modern music, talking about Danny Brown, talking about Jay Dilla, the choice is obvious for me.
Yeah, Idaho.
Tim, did you have something?
No, I was just making the hand.
Ah, yes. Tim was holding up his hand as famously as Michiganders will do to tell you where they're from. They point to the mitten. It's Michigan, guys.
Wow.
That's fair.
Cam, you changed.
You're different, man. Man, wow. Who's next?
Well, in the ninth seed, we're halfway there to the end of this episode.
Oh, God.
Live it on a prayer, baby.
Speeding things up. Here we go.
In the ninth seed, it's Tennessee versus Washington.
Oh, interesting. Okay, Tim, right off the bat, do you want to go ahead and give your take?
Yeah, you know, Tennessee carrying around a frying pan, you know, as flat as a pancake, that state, and it's going to make Washington as flat as a pancake if it's able to get off that first crit strike hit. Washington is bringing an onslaught of whales, though, from the bay, or what's that called? The sound?
The puge.
That's right.
So sound off, it's Washington for me.
Wow. Okay. I mean, I think that's a fair pick. Mohawk, between these two states, who's piquing your interest, Washington or Tennessee?
Well, it depends, because what movies are set in Tennessee?
Oh, man.
There's a TV show I know.
Nashville. And the movie Nashville.
So can the characters from Nashville or Al Gore beat any of the vampires from Twilight who live in Forks, Washington?
Oh man, that's tough.
That's really question. Tough. Great question.
That's what I'm looking at, and I'm thinking Edward Cullen. I'm thinking Jacob. What was Jacob's like? They never told us his last name in those movies, did they?
Jacob Wolf.
That.
You know, here's a matchup, though. In the Dewey Cox story, which I'm pretty sure takes place in Tennessee, Dewey Cox cuts his brother in half with a machete. Mm-hmm. And I'm wondering if there's something in the water there. Because the brother lives.
Ooh, okay. Yeah, true. That's tough. But vampire werewolf fight.
Uh-huh.
And then they can call the Volturian for backup.
Why would they be fighting on the side of Washington? They're Italian vamps.
I mean, they came to Forks, Washington to stop that army of newborns at the end, but they showed up too late and missed the conflict, and the werewolves had escaped after Jacob got his ribs broken. So, like, they do show up. They will pull up to Washington to square up. They've done it. You know, that was the main fear in, like, two different movies in the Twilight franchise. And there's only, like,
fair.
Four or five think, of those. So, I for, like, half fair. The franchise, yeah. But would Tennessee have enough garlic bread to stop the Volturi?
No, absolutely not.
I got to go with Washington.
Wow, okay. Wow. Two votes for Washington. Anthony, I'm going to make you decide because my vote is actually going to be going to Tennessee. Now, I like Washington.
Wrong.
No, I agree. I am wrong. I like Washington more as a state. However, got to go by the celebs and the people from the states. And in this one, it's Dolly Parton from Tennessee versus Katherine Heigl in Washington. The Battle of the Blondes. And Dolly takes this one head over foot for me. Congrats, Dolly. Tennessee gets one vote. Anthony?
Kind of seems like there's another iconic blonde in the history of Washington.
Not musical ones. Definitely not.
Well, you know, Statesman's ending. This is the only time I'll ever get to make this joke. So I'm going to do it right now. It's a little self-indulgent based on what Mohawk was saying. Voltari. Oh, oh.
How is this self-indulgent? What about that?
All right. All right.
I didn't understand that reference.
It's a Dean Martin song, but with vampires now.
Who is Dean Martin?
Wow. Taken aback. Now you've been sunned, Anthony. He sunned your damn ass.
No, I don't care. This is a tough matchup for me because these are two states that are extremely important to my partner. Two of her favorite states in the world, where she's from and where she has had some of the most fun over her life on an iconic vacation she's told me all about. Perhaps somewhere we'll be going soon. Not too soon, but this year, perhaps, once we're both fully vaccinated. I have to say this is made more challenging by the presence of Nashville, somewhere I've always wanted to travel to. But Washington is at the top of my list for states I most want to visit. And it's at the top the very top of the list of states in which I'd want to die. It's the most beautiful state, in my opinion. After all of our review, all of the photos, it is my pick here.
Wow.
Wow.
I looked up Dean Martin and he looks like a leather couch.
Yeah, my man was tanned to the extreme. Drunk in every movie. Incredible.
My man looks like an old man shoe.
Well,
you know those old man shoe, he looks like those loafers, those brown ones that my papa used to wear.
Mm-hmm. Ouch. Poor Dean. Poor Dino. Rest in peace to the big crooner himself. What's our next round, Tim?
He looks racist.
All right, for the next eight rounds, I think we should do a speed round as fast as possible on some of these ones. Missouri and Wisconsin is the 10th seed of the first round. And for me, Missouri fighting with its tears versus a ninja cow, I've got to say that Wisconsin whipping shuriken cheese at the tears of Missouri, cutting through sadness. It's Wisconsin for me.
Okay, wow. A shocking take, but okay. Missouri, for me, it's just one guy, Eminem. But what about Wisconsin? Also, a single man, Zack Snyder. Both of them put upon by the weight of the world and the empires that they hold upon. But, oh, God. If I just have to do Eminem versus Zack Snyder, and this is, by the way, a media contest, I gotta go with who's had the hit recently. Zack just put out a trailer for that new zombie movie in Vegas. Looked entertaining. Eminem's Music to Murder Yourself By is terrible, so I gotta go Zack. Wisconsin gets my vote.
Mohawk, what are you thinking here?
I'm thinking, you know, the ninja cow thing reminded me of Diablo 2, that cow level.
Oh, yeah, sure. The hidden little.
And also, I really like cheese. And I really don't like Eminem. He raps about hitting women so much.
A lot.
So much. And he means it. I don't know. No. I'm voting for cheese. I'm voting for Wisconsin. Hashtag Oberweiss.
Okay, I think, did that decide the round?
It did. Wisconsin did advance.
Yeah, for me, Missouri is all about one man, and that's Tim Ferrari. I was tempted to pick it because of that, but Wisconsin, the memories that we made there on our trip, it wins out for me, for sure.
Absolutely, wow. Good point. Tim, who's our next round?
Well, in the 11th seed of the first round, we've got this is a crazy matchup. Hawaii versus Minnesota. And for me, it's absolutely no competition. The Hawaiian punch is real. Hawaii wins it all.
Yeah, I mean, I can't imagine voting for Minnesota here on any metric. You got to go Hawaii. Come on.
I'm going to vote for Minnesota on a technicality. Hawaii is not a state. It is a sovereign nation that is being illegally occupied by U.S. Wow. imperialism.
A twist.
People just took Hawaii from Hawaiians, planned a coup, and then started illegally occupying Hawaii, and is now like using the tourism industry to absolutely ruin the island. And Hawaii has a huge homelessness issue, and Native Hawaiians make up the largest percentage of that when that didn't used to be a problem before the U.S. illegally invaded Hawaii. The UN even acknowledges, along with the National Lawyers Guild, that Hawaii is not a legitimate state. It is being occupied illegally by the U.S. So Hawaii is not a state, so it is disqualified for me from this conversation, from this competition and this conversation as a big middle finger to the U.S. doing brown people dirty.
Wow. Okay, Minnesota gets a vote. And
Minnesota
gets
a vote because America did Hawaii dirty. Free Hawaii.
Wow. Your logic really is sound there. Obviously, you know, that really might have swung me the other way. Guys, what are we thinking here?
Okay, it's got to come down to this. Vince Vaughn's from Minnesota, so it gets my vote.
Wow.
Cool.
You know, every Vince Vaughn movie is I don't know how to love. Oh, wait, yes, I do.
He learns. He figures it out. Name one Hawaiian celebrity who can love. Bruno Mars? No. Okay, Tim, I believe you had your vote. You went with Hawaii. Anthony, I think it might come down to you.
Wow, I did.
I think Minnesota has two votes right now over Hawaii.
Woo, wow. I came out of the gate voting for Hawaii. Of course, it's where I would most want to die. But, Mohawk did raise some extremely sound points. It should be its own sovereign nation. We should get rid of it.
We should free
get rid of it.
And give those people reparations.
That is definitely, obviously, what I meant. Okay. But I will say Minnesota.
Wow. And you know what? I'm going to go back on it. Even though, liberate Hawaii, of course.
Wow.
But since Hawaii is under the mind control of an evil empire, placing it into this tournament, I've got to go with the fighter.
Wow. Hawaiian punch, do go.
I think that's fair. I think that's very fair. Hawaii, maybe the best state in the union, arguably also one that we should not have. So an interesting argument, and we'll get back to it, but we got to move on.
All right. In the 12th seed, South Dakota versus New Jersey.
Oh, boy. Okay.
This one is very easy for me. Everybody punches, New Jersey all the time. But in this matchup, how could you possibly vote for South Dakota? Boring, racist monuments on stolen land. Get it the fuck out of here. I'm going with New Jersey. It's close to my heart. My New York Giants play there. That's where I'm standing on this one.
Sure. Anthony, do I have to remind you that Brock Lesnar is from South Dakota?
Well, does that change my vote? Absolutely not.
mine neither. I mean, New Jersey is definitely going to take the win on this. New Jersey, not my favorite state, definitely has its own problems. But when going up against such a fucking dip as South Dakota. I mean, it's
not a dip.
A total dip.
Not a dip.
I mean, this place is dip central, baby, and I am not a fan. So I'm going with New Jersey. Jersey gets my vote. Mohawk, what are you thinking between South Dakota and New Jersey?
I was already going to pick Jersey, but learning about Brock Lesnar just pushes me further over the edge of Jersey because Brock Lesnar looks like a racist Machamp.
Yeah, he does. He does, actually. Yeah.
It was like a buzzcut fighting type Pokemon. Like if Lieutenant Surge had a fighting type gym instead, that's Brock Lesnar.
No.
I'm sorry, Tim. Go ahead. My bad.
No, you know what? I think, you know what? You put the words into my mouth. New Jersey is the Machoke of this matchup for me, choking out the Ditto of South
and
Dakota.
Could be the ultimate Machamp, depending on how far it goes. We'll see in the future.
Wow. Okay. Well, in the 13th seed, we've got New Mexico versus Rhode Island.
Oh, wow. Ooh. Now this is a matchup.
Clams.
Come on, baby. Rhode Island, Anthony, it seems today that all you see is this state winning the pick from me. Rhode Island's going to get my vote. Family Guy is filmed there.
Wow.
You know,
wow.
In my opinion, the best kind of warfare is psychological warfare. One where you have the opponent questioning the very reality in which they exist, which is why New Mexico, the only state to have a state question, using it against Rhode Island, confusing it mid-match.
Red or green, baby. Interesting. All right. 1-1. Anthony, who are you going with?
If yellow was an option in that question, you know I'd pick that. But only red or green exist in that question, and I am going with New Mexico as well. I would much rather die there. Rhode Island, another sneaky one that I think deserves a little more credit than it might be recognized with nationally. But New Mexico is somewhere I find much more interesting, and I would rather die in the desert and have my bones be bleached by the sun.
Okay, great. Well,
Mohawk?
Yeah, I think New Mexico has two votes. Rhode Island has one. It all comes down to you, Mohawk.
Ah, see, this is a tough one because America stole Mexico from Mexico and then named it New Mexico. But Rhode Island isn't Rhode Island technically not really an island?
Oh, it's definitely not an island.
Like, it's more of a peninsula, right? Like, it just sort
not
of
even
sticks
that.
Out.
Not,
it's
it
not
has
even
one
it's
coast.
Just there. So
yeah,
it's so it's a liar.
Yes. Yep.
So it wasted my time.
Okay, but Family Guy is filmed there.
Cartoons aren't real. That's another lie.
Wait, what?
Okay.
That's another lie.
You know, psychological warfare is the best kind of warfare, but the second best, the art of deception.
I don't know what red or green means.
The chili sauces.
Oh. Oh.
Yeah, oh, now you're really questioning the nature of your reality.
New Mexico.
New Mexico!
I will mix them together.
That's right. That's Christmas.
Oh, is that good?
Open up your mind, Tim.
Wow.
Oh, boy. Mix them up, baby. Tim, who's next?
In the 14th seed, we've got South Carolina versus Kentucky. Huh.
Okay, this is a tragic matchup. Just two states that have some rough histories as well as some rough current days. So, I mean, if we're looking at some of the celebrities from South Carolina here, I mean, oh, okay, RIP to the King, Chadwick Boseman from South Carolina. Great guy, cool stuff. Mm. But, of course, from Kentucky, we're looking at the true GOAT. Muhammad Ali. Man, this is tough because, yeah.
For me, this round is a little bit of a wash because look at the next round that it's going into. South Carolina or Kentucky is going to be heads up against New York. I'm sorry, but this round is a waste of time.
It truly is. I'll just say I'm going to put my vote in for Kentucky. Better chicken, I suppose. Anthony?
I'm on board with that as well. Obviously, two states that we could have accepted from the competition entirely in favor of, you know, some of the states that we've left on the trail along the way here. But I will go Kentucky as well for those secret herbs and spices.
Ah, okay. Tim, Mohawk?
Tim, you go first.
You go ahead.
Oh, me? Okay.
All right.
Tim.
Well, you know, they say that a chicken can run around with its head cut off, but with what damage New York is going to do to this chicken's head, there's no way Kentucky's living. I'm voting Kentucky.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't know, because on one hand, I love Chadwick Boseman, RIP, and I think the Black Panther could take Muhammad Ali, but if Muhammad Ali had vibranium boxing gloves,
ooh,
that fight would be a bit more fair if it was just a fight in the ring. And, like, I love Muhammad Ali. I love Muhammad Ali so much, like, deeply, like, as a person that I look up to in regards to, like, the conversations that I have about, like, the liberation of my own people. I really do look to some of the things that Muhammad Ali has said. And, yeah, Kentucky. Yeah, it didn't matter because Kentucky won already, but Kentucky.
Yeah, I understand. And again, they're going up against New York, so, like, what?
But fuck Colonel Sanders, though.
Oh, that's true. Yes, also, fuck the Colonel.
Looking like fast food Santa. I don't... He looks like Tim. The inside of those biscuits, just dry. You ever look? Bite into one of those biscuits and look into it?
Cover the kernel in honey. It's good.
If I have to add a sauce to make you good, then you weren't good enough on your own.
Damn! Ouch! Ouch!
Wow! Honestly, this next round this next scene needs a little bit of sauce to make it better because it's Connecticut versus Montana.
Okay. All right. Well, I mean, I don't have to say this. You guys know where she's from. Candace Owens, the queen of Twitter clapbacks and the worst human alive, is from Connecticut. However, people from Montana, I mean, nobody, just nobody, truly nobody. And
Spirit, the Stallion of Samaran, is probably from Montana.
I mean, if that's what we want to go with, I'm just trying to find thing. Literally anyone. And I can't find
lots of.
Oh, David Lynch. Okay, Montana. Boom, you got it. Congrats, Montana.
Wow. I am tempted to pick Montana as the end of my life resting place. What?
I'm sorry. I just saw insane news about Montana, guys. Do you want to get... There's a famous person from here that, I mean, should decide the whole round.
Say it.
Bassist for Pearl Jam, Jeff Ament.
Wow! Wow. Bassist from Pearl Jam, Jeff Ament. Well, we definitely don't have time for him to call in on this episode. Maybe we'll hear from him before we end the show. As tempted as I am to pick Montana for its natural beauty, there are far too many, you know, rich snobs who move there at the end of their life or to escape from the public eye and their taxes. So what I'm going to do is pick the poetic place for me to die, which would be where my very life began in Connecticut.
Oh, wow.
Cyclical. Like a salmon returning from whence you came.
To spawn once again on the eggs of his brethren.
But, you know, Connecticut, for me, it only has those... It's the place with the big houses, right? Or is that Rhode Island?
Kind of both of them. Yeah, both of them have those, like, rich, white, like, 1900s rich people.
I think Tim might be thinking of the Vanderbilt estates, which are in Rhode Island.
Ah, okay. Well, you know, Connecticut's got big big houses anyway. They've got a lot of money. But Montana's got... bison. And if I have anything to say about a bison standing on two legs with a pair of boxing gloves and some shorts on, it's going to be knocking out those rich people in this competition a la Mortal Kombat. I guess the finishing move would be impaled on the horns and then the bison roars. That's pretty cool.
That is very cool.
On the superhero episode, that villain that was a bison was from Montana?
Yes.
That makes me want to go Montana because I don't want to vote for anything that Candace Owens is from. And Queen of Clapback, Queen of Twitter, that's me.
Wow, Mohawk. How dare taking you? It from Candace. Candace, who took it from Chrissy. The chain goes on.
I am hilarious. How dare you put other gods before me? How dare you?
The other gods, Candace Owens. Okay, let's move on to this next round. I don't want to talk about Candace Owens anymore.
The 16th seed. We're getting so close. Pennsylvania versus Illinois.
Oh.
Wow. Mohawk?
Oh, easy. Can Pennsylvania footwork? Right. Does Pennsylvania have Harold's or Uncle Remus? Did Pennsylvania invent house music? Did Pennsylvania, you know what I'm saying? Like, does Pennsylvania have Chance the Rapper? Did Pennsylvania put me on house arrest? Oh, God.
Well,
you could have left Chance the Rapper out completely, dude.
Why'd you gotta bring him in?
Because acid rap was undeniably brilliant, even though I'm not a fan of his later
rap. No, acid rap is bulletproof. We all agree it's a
like
perfect
acid
album.
Rap, 10-day, like, amazing projects that did
serve.
Like, the reason there's so much trumpets in hip hop now is because of Chance the Rapper and Donnie Trump.
Yep.
That happened right here. So it's Illinois for me, but I'm not happy with how my state is treating me right now.
That's fair.
You could have stopped at Uncle Remus is all I'm saying. And Illinois was already far enough ahead.
It's worth noting that Camden did have the love of his life taken away by Chance the Rapper when he got married to this woman, his baby mama. Camden was actively trying to court her. Isn't that right?
Oh, I love my wife. I love my wife.
Okay, Camden. No, Camden. No.
Wait, bro, you were in love with... what is this story? Tell me later.
We should move on. Talk about it off
pod. We don't have time.
Tell me later. Tell me in the privacy of our home.
Kat Dennings is from Pennsylvania.
Wow.
But she's moving here when we get married. That doesn't matter.
That's true. All right, Illinois, you got my vote. Tim?
Wow.
Yeah, you know, for me, Mohawk, you mentioned, you know, footwork comes from Illinois. So much comes, you know, we're in Illinois right now. So, I mean, we're all fighting in this competition, whether we know it or not.
Yeah, like, where did y'all move to? Exactly. Yeah, you didn't go to Connecticut. So you didn't go to Pennsylvania. You came here.
No. I almost went to Pennsylvania. I almost went to Ursinus College.
I was very close to going to school in Pennsylvania at Temple or Drexel as well.
I hope you guys don't mind if I clear out my ursinuses.
I'm so happy you did that.
Okay.
I almost went to NYU.
Damn.
Wow, guys, what could have been? Imagine. Damn. We couldn't have been recording this episode right now if we'd all walked down these different paths. And for that reason, I have to go Illinois, even though Pennsylvania does have a certain place very close to my heart in the Northeast. Illinois for me.
Wow.
All right, in the 17th seed of the first round, we have Maine versus North Dakota.
May I?
Yes.
Yeah.
Think of any monster from a Stephen King novel, and that's who's in the fight.
Whoa!
Against North Dakota,
Cujo, the dog.
Right. The least interesting Dakota, the worst Dakota.
It's brutal that South Dakota can be so boring, and yet there's a Dakota that is also maybe just as boring.
Like there's Dakota Fanning, South Dakota, and then North Dakota in that order.
Yeah, it's tough. It really is tough. I mean, it's worth knowing that maybe Josh Duhamel is from North Dakota.
Who is that?
This is for Anthony. This is for Anthony. Anthony loves Josh Duhamel.
Who is that?
He plays a cop and everything. He's a guy from Justified. He's a great actor, but he typecast as a sheriff with a gun. It's obvious for me as well. Maine, the lobster, the sights, the coast. I gotta go with Maine.
You know, I agree with Mohawk, especially with the monsters. I'm imagining its final move to be the balloon popping and releasing a billion spiders upon the opponent.
God, what a scary... Wait, and I think, isn't that 3 votes for Maine?
Wow.
I love hearing that sound, and I love saying that my vote also would have been for Maine, if only because our favorite... oh my God, there's nobody from fucking Maine. David E. Kelly, he wrote Ally McBeal.
Hold on. I liked Ally McBeal a lot.
Ally McBeal's pretty good, and he's from Maine, which, right there.
Everyone who writes good is from Maine.
Seems that way.
And everyone who pretends to be police is from North Dakota.
Ouch.
Do you think that the car that Ashton Kutcher was having a hard time finding might have been Christine?
So So it drove itself away, you think?
Yeah.
Yep.
To commit crime.
Very quickly.
Yeah. I think it could have been, Anthony.
That's good lore.
I think it could have been. Well, Tim,
in the 18th seed, the final seed of the first round, we've come to the end. It's Louisiana versus Wyoming.
Oh, boy. Mm. This one is tough. I want to put my choice out there early because I don't want it to be influenced by other people's picks. And that is, I'm going with Wyoming. Now, I don't think Wyoming is necessarily the more interesting state. In fact, looking at some of the fucking celebrities from it, I mean, the amount of just like white guys with skinny necks and incredibly large ears is astonishing. But Louisiana is the home state of Jared Leto. And I unfortunately cannot let that go forward in the competition. For my own safety, for our future guest safety, for the listeners in the future, I will not allow that to happen. So after seeing how dangerous he could be in Zack Snyder's cut,
Wait. Zack Snyder's cut?
Zack Snyder is very much uncut, and my vote is for Wyoming. Who's next?
If I may. Wyoming is where one of my most memorable dinosaur digs happened. For those of you who don't know this about me, I studied paleontology before focusing on art. So I've been on three dinosaur digs. And my third one was at Wyoming. I did one big one at Mammoth Site, and then we had one here in Illinois where we found a bunch of trilobites and stuff, which I believe is the state fossil of Illinois. And then we went to Wyoming and we found a stegosaur.
What?
Yeah, we were digging on a stegosaur. Yeah, the paleontologist that had us out there found a stegosaur, and we got to work on that, and it was incredible. And you know, I saw bison there. And I saw a bunch of other cool stuff there. So I love Wyoming. And Louisiana has very good food. Very, very, very good food. But also they fed baby black people to alligators.
Ay, ay, ay.
I think, was that Louisiana?
No, Florida? Thank you.
Wasn't it both?
Probably.
Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know somewhere in the South where there are gators and slavery, they used babies as alligator bait for fun.
Yeah, like, that doesn't shock me at all.
And that makes it hard. That makes it very hard to love Louisiana. But also, Beyonce's mom is from Louisiana.
Oh.
And we would not have Beyonce. We would not have the queen without the empress. I think that's how monarchies work. That's not how monarchies work.
No, that's how it works. It is. Yeah, almost. The empress.
Because I know, like, the king, queen's kids be like dukes and princes and stuff. But, like, you know, I don't know how empress. Yeah, I'm going to wrap it up. It's hard. It's so hard. I got to go with Wyoming because alligator death.
Okay. Mm. Yeah, all right. Anthony, do you want to let us know what you're thinking?
I mean, it's hard to say anything once alligator death is brought to front of mind. I have to go with what I was originally going to say here, though. I did flip my vote previously. I have to stand with Louisiana. You know, obviously, horrible history. But I think that what we discussed on a recent episode, its impact on the musical history of this country is phenomenal. And, this is a vote very much influenced by my brief time in New Orleans and the impact of Big Frida. So I'm going to say Louisiana for me.
Wow. Okay.
You know, this is getting close. This is a close match so far. And let me explain myself. I think that both of these fighters are incredibly unique fighters, but only one problem with a couple of them. Wyoming, a little bit broad, a little bit boring, a little bit of a vanilla fighter.
Okay.
But but it's got those dinosaur bones and is able to conjure sort of this necromancy sort of magic, you know?
Very JoJo, very cool.
Louisiana is a smash good hitter. You know, it's got that big New Orleans punch. But what about the rest of Louisiana? I mean, we really haven't heard about it on the show. Its moveset is a little bit unknown to me. So I'm going with Wyoming simply because I imagine its finishing move to conjure up some sort of shamble of dinosaur bones from the ground to sort of flurry Robin Hood the opponent and yes.
Prehistoric pummeling.
Exactly.
Camden, hit the little ditty.
Wow.
It's official.
Love Jack and Diane.
A little ditty sucking down chili dogs outside the Tasty Freeze. And we sucked down a couple chili dogs of our own on this fun episode. That was 18 rounds, and it certainly felt like it.
Wow.
Yeah, it really did feel like it. But an incredibly entertaining 18 rounds. We saw a lot of blood.
Oh, blood, guts, viscera, states.
Ooh, I'm already looking forward to some of these matchups for next week. This is going to be a brutal, brutal fight to the finish. There's going to be so much more to talk about. But we left a lot of really great contenders behind. So just a moment of respect with those states that did not make it past this round.
Yeah, they say
I mean, Mohawk, you accompanied us for the first round, but I've got to ask, who do you think is going to be making it to the final round? Who's great your state question to win it all?
Final round? Good. New York's probably going to make it pretty far.
Yeah.
New York's probably going to make it. And it's either going to be somewhere from the West Coast or somewhere from the Midwest that's going to take it. Because every time somebody brings up how racism happened, like especially like in a Southern state, which you know, ain't super fair because everywhere was racist. Whole continent colonized, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Very much so.
But every time somebody brings up racism in a Southern state, that Southern state ends up losing outright. And like they're running out of states.
That's true. Florida, I mean, Florida's in that second round, and I think Florida has some staying power, but
no,
it's also a fucking shithole. Florida
is in Florida where isn't that where Stand Your Ground, homie?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah. Trayvon. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Like, yeah, nah. Mm-mm. Yeah, nah. Florida. I would vote against Florida, but that ain't my business because that ain't my episode.
Thank you for staying in your lane on this.
I'm not trying to influence the next person to vote against Florida. New guest, that's not me.
We'll see how it goes. I do want to just mention, I mean, our next episode is going to be dangerous. It's going to be violent. It's going to be a goddamn mortal state bat. And thank God that doing all my research for famous people from states, an ad kept popping up on this website with the famous 50 people. And the ad was specifically for stab-proof tactical vests. So I'm, yeah, just watch out. I might be vested up on our next episode. So Anthony, I don't care if you're a knife guy, you can't stop me.
Yeah, I can't use my famous weapon on you in order to get you to get over here. But guys, this was a real success. I was excited throughout. I was coming into this episode with a sense of dread, A, about the task that we have at hand, you know, the ultimate decision, the crowning of the ultimate state, but also dread about the end of the podcast. You know, it's meant so much to me. It's been such a wild ride. And I just wanted to take this opportunity to say, Mohawk, thank you for being such a great friend of the show and for coming on several times. You always bring the most fun energy to the show and our lives. You know, you're such a great guy and a great friend to all of us, and we can't thank you enough for sharing this episode with us and all of these memories that we made along the way. Especially, you know, you're a two-time guest in the same episode. You had to re-record your episode after we got all the way through and it crashed. And that's a very small but powerful club. So we really appreciate we really appreciate your time, and we love you.
I love all of you too. And you know, I would do it again in a heartbeat. I would re-record that episode and any other episode y'all needed me on in a heartbeat if anything went wrong.
Thank God we don't have to re-record this one, because the quality has been through the roof, and I'm just excited for people to listen to us ramble on for like the first chunk of this episode is wild, and I'm very excited for folks to hear it. And honestly, Mohawk, just thank you so much for coming on. Is there anything that you want to plug for folks at home to listen to or check out?
If it comes out before 9 a.m people should come to my court support, which is also on 420.
Damn, what?
Oh,
at 9 a.m I have court on 420.
Damn. Yeah. Wow. So for anyone who caught a series of little bumpers in the summer for Statesmen, Mohawk's been dragged through the mud of the awful gauntlet that is the legal system since being arrested from a protest this past August. We try to, when weather permits, we try to show up at the Cook County Courthouse at 26th and California. So if you're in Chicago and you want to come out and support Mohawk while his pre-trial is going on, that's where we'll be, 9 a.m. The date this airs, 4:20.
Word. And if anybody wants to follow my new TikTok, it's called Techno Jail.
Techno Jail.
Because that's what's happening to me. And I talk about, like, I talk about, like, how, you know, no matter how anybody feels about, like, me personally or, like, any charges that are happening, like, it's not okay that, like, house arrest monitors go off as frequently as they do, and how those are used in court cases to, like, show that people can or can't be subordinate because of how inaccurate the data is and how badly they work. Like, there are people who are sitting in cells because their monitors go off while they're at home, and that has happened to me. I had sheriffs show up at my house today because that happened to me.
And I think you can kind of broaden that same feeling. Like, no matter how you feel about a lot of the people who may or may not have done something technically illegal, whoever it may be in whatever state, that does not, like, it does not qualify the things that are done against them or by the police or by the other side. It's like essentially just a long-term torture to eventually make somebody try and take a plea deal. Or, I mean, like, I don't want to really get into what's going on right now in Minnesota, but, like, it doesn't matter whether or not somebody did something wrong. Nobody has the right to take someone's life away or take someone's freedom away from them. So we're praying for you, bud. And 26th and California on 4:20, we'll be outside the courthouse throwing eggs at whoever the other team is.
Please don't do that on my back.
I think that would really help.
Be respectful. Also, buy fucking Mohawk's music on Bandcamp. Go on Bandcamp, download all of his music. It's fucking incredible. And it's just, there's so much there to listen to and listen through. And it's just great art. You got to check it out.
Absolutely, yeah. So we'll keep a link in there. But Anthony, Tim, do you guys have anything you'd like to plug?
You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Scorpion.
nice.
Or my public account at I'm A Rossi.
You can follow me on Instagram at younggarlic, YUNG_garlic. And you can follow me on Twitter at infected_butt.
And you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Stuart Hicar, StuartHicar, like you're saying hi to a car. There is no low car. He is dead. I have taken his place. Thank you again, Mohawk, so much for coming on. But I think that just about does it for us.
Whoa.
Wow.
Not going to let me plug, guys.
Yeah, Camden.
Oh, I'm fuck. Sorry.
Stu.
Sorry.
Twitter and Instagram at camstacey_ CamStacey_. Just because the story's been going on for so long, if you want to find out more about Mohawk's story with his arrest, etc., just search out #FreeMohawk on any social platforms. And you'll find plenty of media there, lots of papers writing about him.
Great piece in the Chicago Reader that came out that everyone should check out.
Yeah, #FreeMohawk.
I'm a hairstyle.
Well, on behalf of my junior statesman Anthony Rossi and Stuart Hicar, I'm your older statesman Tim Ferrari. State positive.
Vince Vaughn, my favorite actor.
Get out of here!
Whoa!
Oh, man. All right, stop the record.
Okay.